So you want to create a registration form in HTML, but you keep running into some roadblocks. Or perhaps this is the first time that you're undertaking such a task and you just want a helping hand to figure out where to actually begin. Well, don't worry, because coding even the simplest of things can often be tiresome and frustrating. So we decided to break down this process into 6 easy to follow steps, but make sure you stick around to the end of this video where we look at an easier no code solution. Let's go. G'day everyone, Alex from Paperform here. Now, I understand that you're trying to create a registration form in HTML. So we at Paperform decided to break down this process into 6 easy to digest steps, starting with step numero uno, choosing your text editor. Now, much like you need a word processor to create a text document, you need a text editor to create your code. And I use VS Code or Visual Studio Code because it's free, incredibly customizable, incredibly fast, and it supports syntax highlighting, bracket matching, hundreds of languages, and much more. But don't take my word for it, because there is a vast number of text editors out there. So I've gone ahead and linked Paperform's jumbo list of web development tools to the description of this video. Go ahead, take a look at that, and decide which text editor is best for you. So once you've decided, it's time to get down to business. Creating your HTML file. Go ahead, open your text editor, and create a new file. And save it with the HTML extension, of course. You can label your form however you like. I'm going to label mine the best registration form ever created. And once you've signposted to the editor that you're creating HTML code, it should automatically generate the following code you see here. However, some text editors won't autofill, but not a problem. I've actually linked in the description of this video the code that we'll be using in step number 3, adding basic text fields. Now, if you're new to HTML, you're about to step into muddy waters, and the following might look like some random letters and symbols, but don't worry, you don't need to understand what they mean. But the creation process and troubleshooting of your code, of course, is going to be much easier if you have a handle of the basics. However, this video can provide you with the know-how to create a basic registration form from scratch. Now, we're going to add the following code you see here. I'll just paste that, which, as I said, you can find in the video's description. And it will turn your current bare bones HTML file into a registration form. There we can see I've got the title, the best registration form ever created, which is a lie. Now, an HTML form is made up of form elements. There are things like headings, tables, text boxes, buttons, checkboxes, drop-down menus, and much more. Now, these elements make it possible for your viewers to interact with the form. Each element has its own specific tag. Let me show you what I mean. Now, those tags are the words in between the chevrons. Chevron, what's a chevron? Well, a chevron is that V-shaped line or stripe you see there. For example, the HTML form tag defines your code as a form, while the table tag defines an HTML table. These elements are like shoes. They always come in pairs. So all tags you include in your form must have an opening and closing tag. Following? Yes, no, maybe. Well, let's run this code and see what we have created so far, as it's always easier to understand what you're creating when you can visualize it. So on your text editor, find the run button and select it. Our basic HTML code will output the following. But how did our code create that? Well, back into the code, notice the tag TR. This tells your form to arrange the elements in a row, while TD, which stands for table data, signals that you want to capture whatever the respondents type. In this instance, we added 2 fields, first name and last name. All right, on to step 4 already, adding additional fields. We currently have a basic form asking respondents for their first name and last name. I think we need to add some other fields. How about an email field? Pretty important to capture an email address of a registrant, yes, maybe. So take a look at the following code we have here. This is the code we use to create a text input field, more specifically our first name field. We can alter that code to create an email field. Let us change the question title from first name to email address and change the input type from text to email and the field name from fname to email. Now, the field name value will be how you internally identify your field, so don't stress too much about this. All right, so we've created an email address. Let's look at adding another field, maybe to collect the submitter's phone number. So using that same code, we'll just copy and paste, and we'll change again the question title, this time to phone number, and the input type to tell. Let's also quickly change the field name, and voila. Now, the most important thing to take away from this is the input type. This tells the form how the response should be formatted, so the submitter will receive an error if they've done it incorrectly. If you want to add any other question types to your form, but you're unsure how to label your input type, W3 Schools has a great list to guide you, which, once again, I have diligently linked into this video's description. Don't worry, I'm here for you. Now, selecting the correct input type is crucial. If you're wanting to add extra fields to your registration form, follow the same format. Just note that all tags you include in your form must be inserted between the open form and closed form tags. And don't forget, shoes come in pairs. Now onto step number 5, adding placeholders. Placeholder text appears inside form fields and prompts respondents to answer in a particular way or to follow a particular format. It's basically a nudge in the right direction and also a useful way to make your form that much more engaging. Now, let's look at a quick example. It's fairly simple to add placeholders to your HTML. So after the input type, just insert placeholder equals. Now, I'll do this to the first name field. So we'll jump there and we can do placeholder equals, and I'll make the placeholder your first name. Let's run our code and voila, there we have it. Our registration form with our 4 question fields and a placeholder text. But hang on, how is the respondent meant to submit the form? We haven't added a submit button. So that's onto the final step and the easiest, step number 6, adding a submit button. Much like you can include a question field type by altering the input type, you can include a submit button by including the input type submit. So go ahead and copy the following code, which I've added to the video description, and hit run. Now the input type is, well, we've talked about this, but the value will be the text shown on the submit button. If I change the value to go on, I dare you to press me, then I select run, we can see that our submit button text has changed. Now, I'm sure you're looking at your form and you're thinking, ugly, boring, not up to my standard. Well, not up to my standard either. I think we can both agree that we should not be sharing this particular registration form with any of our potential clients, customers, friends. So how can we beautify it? Well, if you have an understanding of HTML or CSS, go ahead. You no longer need me if you even did at the beginning. If not, take a look at W3 Schools where you can learn how to code pretty quickly. But while I still have your attention, may I ask why you want to go through the unnecessary, painful, elaborate process of creating your forms through HTML, considering there is now a vast number of alternative no-code solutions. With these, you can build booking forms, event forms, registration forms, surveys, quizzes, even fully functional e-commerce stores. These platforms have the back-end power you need and the design functionality that you want. But where should you start? Well, personally, my pick of the bunch is Paperform. Now, I know that is probably a biased opinion, but I truly do believe it. See, Paperform was designed to allow the freedom and creativity that coding offers, all without the hassle of needing to learn to code. But if you don't believe me, no problem. We actually offer a 14-day free trial period with no credit card details required. So what are you waiting for? Head to the description of this video where I've left a link for you to sign up to that 14-day free trial. I'll be looking out for the forms that you create. I just hope that they're a bit more beautiful than the form we created today. Good luck and have fun creating.